Well, the first thing I want to tell Kenyans is that, you know, war is a series of battles. And if you are in a war, you must understand that you will win some battles, you will lose some battles. Some of them will be neutral, some of them will be devastating, some of them will have to be repeated. If you look at the history of war, particularly the Second World War, people will argue which were the most important battles. And high among them was the battle for, you know, of the skies, the engagement of the German Air Force with the British RAF. Winston Churchill was to say later that never in the history of mankind has so much been owed by so many to so few, because of the gallantry and the bravery of the English pilots that were able to down the German planes. And Hitler, from that moment on, made a decision that he could not conquer England from the sky. And that began to affect his strategies, including opening the second front to attack Russia and Moscow. But also, Hillary, we are reaching a point of reckoning where everybody is actually being held to task, including the Gen Z movement. You know, over ambition, there's a Chinese saying that talks about ambition, that ambition without knowledge is like a ship on land. And sometimes, you know, if you are over ambitious in your strategies, you lose the war because you lose battles that you should have won. And right now, sometimes in this revolution, there's a lot of infighting as well as there is advancements. Who owns these victories? Who owns the title? Is it a Gen Z revolution, or is it a Kenyan revolution? Is it being led by this group or that group, or is it an anti-Ruto coalition that is fighting for change? You know, Machiavelli, in his book The Prince, talked about that you to win, a prince must have half skill and half fortune. We must remember that underlying this head-to-head with William Ruto's despotic regime is the issue of the economy. That this economy is actually in ICU. That the tax regimes that he was proposing are because 7 out of 10 shillings goes to the payment of debt, and the other 3 will not be able to sustain the economy. And that continues to become the burden that is put on Kenyans. So as you execute this war, some fundamentals will not change. William Ruto has been dealt his card by fate. He's got an economy that he cannot run away from. Reappointing the cabinet and going around the country holding roadside meetings will not change the economy or the fundamentals that put people to the street. This is this because the highest and the biggest motivation for us, the cost of living, which is tied up to this energy. We must remember that the economy is hurting Kenyans every day. So the motivation is not so much the bullets that try to fail our children. What is the motivation is that people cannot live under these circumstances in Kenya for another 3 years. And therefore, the urgency of the moment is because we must change things. And to change things, we are changing not just dictator William Ruto, but the way in which the entire regime, and in fact, the way in which the ruling class has governed us. Why do we need 47 counties when we could have 8 counties? In fact, Nairobi should be run by the central government like Washington, D.C., and the other could be reduced to 7 counties for costs. Why do we have a woman leader when we don't need that, and the cost of running government, parliament, MCAs, etc.? So if we remember and recalibrate, that the problem that we have underscoring all our problems is the cost of living and therefore an unbearable burden on Wananchi, then we refocus, and that becomes then a war, yes, dominated by Gen Z, of course, by their numbers, but also dominated by all other Kenyans who are living under those strenuous circumstances. And therefore, what is the way forward? Revolutions that are fought against the economy are many, from Mahatma Gandhi to the French Revolution, and the American, in the Declaration of Independence against King Edward of England, when they said that no more taxes can go to England without representation. And therefore, if you look at where Kenya has reached now, it has reached a point where the ruling class have decided to consolidate with the dictator. But I want to remind this country that Africa has had worse dictators. I remember Dr. Idi Amin Field Marshall. I mean, that man was as brutal. He makes Zakayo look like a priest. I mean, he was hounded out of Uganda. He was a military general of self-description. He used to call himself a field marshal. He used to kill and maim Ugandans, at will. But they were able to overcome him. Samuel Doe, Kamuzu Banda, Emperor Bokassa. Here in Sudan, you had the changes that came that people could not even believe a military general could be deposed in Sudan, which was, a functioning military state dictatorship. So there is no doubt that we can triumph against Zakayo using the economy as the backbone of this revolution and this struggle. But where we must go is to be able to allow these younger guys who are very vocal to also understand there is wisdom in age and experience. That some of us from the 90s have been through this kind of process when the Forum of Restoration of Democracy was founded by Jaramogi Oginga Odinga, Kenneth Matiba, and at that time, the former Mayor Rubia and others who were able to come together, Wamalwa Kijana and various other people from all over the country, Baramarawis from the coast. And those struggles in the 90s can be mirrored to the struggles today. Those guys were then the Young Turks. And the issue was that at that point, we were looking for democratic and multi-party government. Now we are looking for economic emancipation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, Tony. And we really appreciate your ideas and also the march as you the history and also the issues, what we can do and the way forward. And thank you so much for coming to this place. And also, I
Hillary, I don't think if Tony had landed, you just interrupted him as he was speaking.
Tony, yes, I was just going to conclude, but then you came onto the space.
Okay, I'm sorry about that. Conclude, bro. Conclude. Yes.
I wanted to lend my weight and my prayers to this idea of Nane Nane, because Nane Nane may, actually go down in history the same way the March of Washington, led then by Martin Luther King, came into history. It can become the amalgamation, the glue that sticks us together, the kind of light that we need to be able to give life to this month of experience we've had against Zakayo. So I wanted to say that the idea and the founding fathers of this idea of Nane Nane are no different. In fact, it is better well thought than when we did Saba Saba. I want to add my voice to support it and a cry on call that if we can now start working toward a target, having a day, because it's very hard to organize weeks of protest and everyday protest, but we can actually put our forces together, have one thing, because when the March of Washington was done on that day in 1963, a million people marched onto Washington. And at that point, the American trajectory of the civil rights movement was changed forever. So I want to appeal this day on this forum at this space that let's also have a target. Let's have D-Day. Let's have a day when we can say we are meeting with Zakayo and we are meeting with him with all our force and all our strength. And there is time to organize and there's a time to raise the funds and the organization for medical camp, for whatever is necessary. How can we put that together so as Kenya we can come and make Nane Nane an Independence Day in Kenya's history? That's all I want to say for now.
Thank you so much. I want to give this mic to my co-host. I see Maji, you carry up your hands, Kingsman, and everything. Everybody, welcome to the space, and let us continue to follow the rules. And also, when you open a mic, you have background noise. Make sure that you are in a quiet place.
Asante sana kwa kutazama Wasos TV. Kama uko na maoni niachie hapo kwenye comment section. Kama hujasubscribe kwenye Wasos TV na kuomba uweze kusubscribe. Huyo amekuwa ni Tony Gachoka ambaye ni mwanahabari, sijui ni mstaafu, amekuwa akizungumza pale kwenye space. So naomba tu niachie comment yako hapo kwenye comment section. Kama uja subscribe mara nyingine, na kuomba uweze kusubscribe TV kama kawaida. Unajua ni Wasos TV. Asante sana kwa wakati wako, na ukue na siku njema.